Are you guys ready?
I'd like to think of myself as more than just a narrator. Think of me as a guide, a shining light for you to follow that will lead you through this
epic. Lights are good. Lights are good.
Jordan! Can I get a little check for the band?
Great. Is everyone in places? What do you mean? Where's Chris? It's the day of the show. How is he not here? Understudies, this is Sing. We don't have understudies. You want him to go on?
This is getting ridiculous. I'm an artist. I refuse to work under normal.
Nate, aren't you forgetting about these lovely people? Our audience?
And who are you?
Me? I'm Natalie B. Narrator. But you can think of me as more than just a narrator. Think of me as a guy. A shining light. Just like we're friends, chilling and having some fun. Right, folks? Are you ready?
Started!
Are you serious? Are you kidding me? What was that? That dance? Seriously? That yelling and screaming does not belong in a theater.
I'm sorry, are you talking about this yelling and screaming?
No! That doesn't belong in a theater!
Buddy, you got a lot to learn!
But how will they?
Learn a moral. Don't worry, we can still have fun and learn a lesson. Check it, this story follows Josie Smith.
Josie? Josie's a total brat! Look at her! She thinks she can judge a person just based on their looks.
Yeah, like someone I know. Anyways, along with Josie, this story follows her boyfriend, Chad.
Chad? Seriously? Chad's a total blockhead! I think we should tell them about Eugene. You see, Eugene's a kind boy. Sure, he's a little bit awkward, but I mean, who isn't awkward when they get nervous? See, sometimes I tend to rattle on when I get nervous, and my mom took me to the therapist about it, but he ended up blaming her. She ended up blaming the dog. The dog ended up blaming the cat.
Yo, Nathaniel B. Narrator, let's get back to our job, narrating. You see, folks, it's the first day of summer vacation, and let's just say Josie and her brothers have some pretty big plans.
Alright, put the talk in. Let's get this party started!
gonna get us some snacks, all right?
Okay, go ahead, snacks.
Go on and get some snacks.
Hey, Chad, what are you doing?
I'm going to get some snacks.
We should, like, totally leave this night party.
But what about Josie?
Josie's so dumb, she's never gonna notice we're gone. Let's get out of here, ladies.
Can you guys hear that loud gasping noise?
Whatever.
Yeah. This party's awesome.
Nah.
So, about that, how would you feel if I told you that I told you like?
That's tough.
Yeah, let's not focus on that.
Here to study abroad for the summer because of her
grace and sophistication on our stage. Pleasure to meet you, my lady.
How charming. The pleasure's all mine.
Your Highness, the Warbot has prepared for your arrival. This way.
You're just made a princess!
And I'm dressed like this. I need no change. You got this.
Wait, we're out of what? Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, while the future king of England gawks over his newfound love, let's check back in on Josie and the gang at the boardwalk, where they thought they would find Chad, but only to be met with a new obstacle.
Okay, so that freak said he has some weird skee-ball tournament. He has to be here somewhere in the boardwalk. We need to find him and get Chad back. What the heck is that?
What about Bronson? Well, can people like LeBron James? Ew. Or Taylor Swift? Ew! What the heck are you?
I'm so smug and angry. But you can point that. It's nice to meet you.
Great! Just what we need. Some stuck-up princess blocking your path.
Rosie, this is royalty. I'm so sorry.
She's a normal girl who likes a party just as much as the next one.
No need to remind me.
That's just it, man.
You're like Josie.
Just like Josie?
Yeah, you both think that your way of thinking is the only way there is. She thought Meg was gonna be this royal stuck-up brat, and now they're probably gonna throw their next party together.
Great, but I thought this was Josie's story, not mine.
You know what? You're right. Back to the stories, ladies and gentlemen. Josie and the gang follow Eugene into the funhouse, only to be met with another unlikely friend.
Wait! What unlikely friend?
The emo girl.
Seriously? Now there's an emo girl too? What's she gonna do? Complain us all to death?
Can it ain't?
Those emo kids and their music and their makeup!
Thank you.
Watch this.
Find Eugene and rescue him.
with rooms like that.
You're like, you don't know about me, Toots.
All right, Miss Mildred. I really hated that duel, but I'm giving you one last chance. Where is she?
Josie's getting desperate.
We searched for him literally
that we just saw Chad at the boardwalk instead of being at your bar party. And what makes it even worse is that he's with other girlfriends.
Oh my gosh!
I used to be a certified lover boy, but honestly, never mind. It's her loss.
Why are you
Oh.
Why can't I use my fingers to solve the problems and time to cancel?
Matt, I think Beth is stalking you again.
Beth! Beth! It has been 3 months! We are over!
That is such a cool story, you know? But what are you doing after school?
What are you talking about?
Like, you know, after school, like hanging out.
I know what you meant, but what about the game?
We have plenty of time. Don't worry.
What about the missing kids?
Who cares if a few kids go missing? Just put their face on a note card and call it a day.
If that isn't the issue, the people that do go missing go to our school.
So?
What do you mean, so? Doesn't it bother you that most of the kids who do go missing go to our school?
Nope.
And why not?
Because I don't let negatives get to me.
Well, clearly nothing gets to you because of your thick skull.
What did you say?
That just proves my point.
We can be back before prayer.
What do you have in mind exactly?
We should support the abandoned mansion.
Are you crazy? Isn't it haunted?
That's what they all say, but ghosts aren't real. Just like the Queen Mary said, lots of British people.
Anyways, we should go. It is abandoned, so no one can catch us, and we're not going to get in trouble. Fine. I'll agree to this crazy plan. Everybody in favor of going, say bye.
Bye.
Sam.
I don't know, guys. I have studying to do, and it's allergy season.
Shush! You're coming.
Fine, but if I die, it is your fault.
Was 5 minutes ago when you last asked.
Oh, forgive me, sir.
All we know are the kids going missing are all Miller Grove students. Thus, we have a connection. Deputy, get the car started. We'll head back there to check some records.
Can we get donuts on the way?
Do you have donut money?
Afraid not, sir.
Then what do you think my answer is going to be?
No.
Finally, write about something, Deputy. Let's go.
Oh, yeah. I want to see all the records for the missing teams.
I want to see if there's any possible connections, if there were friends, etc.
Of course. Anything you need, Sheriff Allen.
You can call me Thomas.
All right, Thomas. I'll be right back with your records.
Humongous.
Yeah, and it reeks. Why did we come here? This place is history, Michelle.
It was built in the 1800s by some rich family that came from England.
And why do you even know that?
Well, I like history.
Clearly, you like history, young girl.
Like you have any right to say anything, Donnie Darko.
That's darn military recruiters calling me?
Just fine.
I can't. Then the laws will come.
Then you won't mark it. I have been trying to reach you, but it seems like your phone isn't working.
My phone fell into a puddle. I mean, the toilet. I made a puddle in the toilet. Yes.
I will get rid of the bullies! Everyone will thank me for my work!
Ivan.
Wait.
I'm waiting.
That last name, say it again.
Vaughn?
Yeah, it sounds so familiar.
I think it's at the beach place over on Cherry Road.
No, you imbecile. Up on the hill. That's Vaughn Manor. That could be where Matthew is, and we could question him. About the disappearances?
Oh, yeah. Today I'm getting food. Can we get donuts on the way?
Fine. We only get two, max. Good idea. I'll get myself some donuts.
Yay!
Matthew, where are you?
Oh, we're back when we came in.
You are alone right now. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? Knock people out with an algebra.
last one standing.
Can't be late.
Come on, listen.
Well, seeing as you have no parents or guardians or anybody who can legally take care of you, and you have committed many crimes, some small, some very, very, very high-level crimes, I will say, I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Well, in the meantime, you can bug me your call. I will warn you, he does not, so.
I'm sure he loves a new company.
What are you in for?
I was planning on joining Junior Freshers here. Apparently, it's legal to willingly join a bad show.
Parents. Now 5 years after, we're still documenting the lives of what happened after. Brad found finally passing out if I was able to graduate and become a mechanic. Diane went on to attend Harvard and become a law student. Her father was elected to be mayor, due to his avoid paying taxes.
I want to become a fashion designer, and now chop. Sam went on to become a history teacher where he still gets bullied by kids, but at least gets paid for it. Matthew is still awaiting his trial and still bumping compulsively.
Previous Sheriff of Miller Grove, Thomas Allen, became married and moved away with his wife, Mrs. Allen. Sheriff Jonah is now in charge of Miller Grove's underfunded police department, but now crime rates have dropped ever since his promotion. And senior song proceeded to sing 2023! Oh, yeah!
Thank you.
choreography! Yes, choreography! Sing your song! For acting! Yes, acting category! Sing your song!